Hello friends, welcome to EduTap. I welcome you all in the rapid session of general awareness and we'll be discussing the most important current affairs of 21st and 22nd of June 2021. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and join our Telegram channel for the free data and the notification of our session. The content which we are providing you friends is really very very helpful for your examination. We are providing you daily exam booster of general awareness, ESAI current affair report and indices. Now, superstar of the session are Nikhil, Ganesh, Anjali, Pooja Awasthi, ABCDEF, Amit Ram and Sunaina, Nil Pujari, Mala Kumari, Dinu Priya, Sagar Patel, Kapil, KK and Neil who have given the right answer to the homework question. And thank you so much friends for participating over there. I request everyone to please answer the homework question which are given to you. So next. Question number 1 says, friends, who among the following has been appointed as the additional judge of Guwahati High Court? And the right answer to this question is option number C, that is Robin Fukan. But we will play with the option. If I talk about Vikas Behl, I hope you remember that he has been appointed as the additional judge of your Punjab and Haryana High Court. If we talk about Kareem Khan, he has sworn in as the new chief prosecutor of International Criminal Court, friends. And ICC's headquarters are present in Hague, Netherlands. If we talk about Sanjay Yadav, friends, he has been appointed as the Chief Justice of your Allahabad High Court. All these news, all these appointments I have discussed with you. We are just revising them here again and again. Anand Mohan Bajaj, friends, has been appointed as the Additional Secretary in the Department of Economic Affairs, friends, okay, as a member of SEBI. I hope this is clear to you. So, friends, recently, President of India has appointed your Robin Fukan as the additional judge of Guwahati High Court in Assam for 2 years. Now, friends, I've said Assam. Now, let's discuss about the national parks of Assam. Dibru-Saikowa, friends, Manas, Nameri, Orang, Kaziranga are the national park of Assam. Recently, two new national park has been added in the list, that are Raimona and your Dihing Patakai, which we have discussed, and total 7 national parks are present in Assam. I hope this news is clear to you. Now friends, India has signed an MOU with which of the following countries in the area of environment? So the right answer to this question is, recently India has signed an MOU with Bhutan, okay, in the area of environment. Now let's play with the option. China is present here. I hope you remember related to China that capital of China is Beijing. If I talk about bilateral exercise between India and China, it is hand in hand, friends. Next, friends, China has recently launched Heyang 2D, an ocean observatory satellite, into orbit. Now, the satellite will give notification related to marine disaster and China will take preventive measures accordingly. One new meteorological satellite has also been launched by China, naming Fengyun 4B. I hope you remember this. It will give information related to weather analysis and your environment disaster. Now friends, one more new, you know, satellite which has been launched. That is, we have discussed in the previous video that China has launched Shenzhou 12 crewed spacecraft, friends. It's not a satellite. It's a crewed spacecraft, friends, to the Tangyong space station, in which, friends, 3 male astronauts will send to space for 3 months for a mission. I hope this much is clear. So China and Russia, friends, together building world biggest nuclear power plant in 2 Chinese cities. 4 big nuclear power plants will be set up. If we talk about Russia, friends, capital St. Petersburg and Moscow, and India and Russia bilateral exercise name Indra. So I hope related to China and Russia, it's clear. And one more point I remember related to Russia, which I will link and connect here, is that, friends, Russia has recently launched first batch of 17,000 doses of COVID for animals. Okay, so it became the first country to launch COVID vaccines for animals. Now, friends, in your option, El Salvador is present here, and we have discussed or related to El Salvador in the previous video that it became the first country in the world to adopt Bitcoin as a legal tender. I hope it's clear. Capital of El Salvador is your San Salvador, friends. I hope you remember. And if I talk about currency, it's Bitcoin and your US dollar. If you talk about Israel, friends, okay, and if you talk about Iran, now related to Iran, I hope you remember that a warship naming Kharg has caught fire and sank in the Gulf of Oman, and this warship belongs to Iran. This news was recently there and we have discussed this. Now, Israel. New president has been elected for Israel. His name is Isaac Herzog. I hope you remember. And Naftali Bennett has been appointed as the prime minister of Israel. If I talk about the capital, it's Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. And Israel is surrounded by Mediterranean Sea, Red Sea and your Dead Sea. We have discussed all these things in the videos. I hope all these things are clear to you. Now friends, India has signed an MOU with Bhutan. Capital of Bhutan is friends Thimphu. Okay, remember this. And the MOU has been signed for developing cooperation between the two countries in an area of environment. Can be asked in your examination. Okay, so capital is Thimphu. And if I talk about the currency, it's Bhutanese Nalutram. I hope friends, this is clear. So who among the following has been elected as the president of Iran? Now, president of Israel is Isaac Herzog. Okay, now president of Iran has been asked. And the right answer to this question is option number C. That is, Ebrahim Raisi is the president of Iran, recently elected president of Iran. So friends, let's discuss about the options. As we will discuss each and every options, they are recent appointments. Akriti Chopra, I hope you remember, has been appointed as the co-founder of your Zomato. Discussed in previous video. Keep on revising, keep on linking, guys. If I talk about Chandrasekhar Ghosh, he has been appointed as the MD and CEO of your Bandhan Bank, friends. This also we have discussed in the video. K. Nagaraj Naidu, friends, has been named as Chef de Cabinet by United Nations General Assembly's President. That is Abdullah Shahid. He has been recently appointed as the President of 76th session of your United Nations General Assembly, friends. Now, Abdullah Shahid is the Foreign Minister of Maldives. If I talk about Maldives, the capital of Maldives is Male, friends. Remember this. And one more thing related to Maldives is India and Maldives signed an MOU on sustainable urban development. I hope you remember this. Done. And then it's Satya Nadella, friends. Satya Nadella, we have discussed previously only in the previous video, has been named as the chairman of your Microsoft. I hope this is clear. So option number C, Ebrahim Raisi, is the right answer to this question. So recently, Ebrahim Raisi, friends, has been elected as the new president of your Iran. If we talk about capital of Iran, that is Tehran. And the currency of Iran is Iranian Rial. Okay, friends, remember this. Now, he is currently serving as the Chief Justice of Iran. Okay, and now appointed as the President of Iran. Now, he will be succeeding, friends, Hassan Rouhani for this post. I hope this news is clear. So, question number 4. Dash has been honored with the European Inventor Award 2021 in the Non-European Patent Officer Countries category. So, the right answer to this question is your option number A, that is Sumita Mitra. Before we discuss about this news, let's play with the option. Vishwaveer Ahuja, I hope you remember this name, friends. We have discussed many of time related to Vishwaveer Ahuja. Vishwaveer Ahuja has been appointed MD and CEO of your RBL Bank. I hope you remember, guys. BVR Subramaniam has been appointed as the Commerce Secretary. Subodh Kumar Jaiswal has been appointed as the director of your central CBI. Okay, Central Bureau of Investigation. Dr. Patrick Amoth has been appointed as the chairman of your World Health Organization, WHO, headquarters, Geneva, Switzerland. Related to Switzerland, I always remember International Hockey Federation. The headquarters are present in Switzerland and the name of the president is Narendra Batra. He has been recently appointed as the president of International Hockey Federation. All these things we have discussed earlier and I hope you are liking the way we are keep on revising things and they are learned by you by heart. I hope this, friends. So let's discuss, friends. Recently, she's an Indian-American chemist. Her name is Sumita Mitra, friends. She has been honored with European Inventor Award 2021 in the Non-European Patent Office Countries category. Now, friends, this European Inventor Award is presented annually, okay, by European Patent Office to recognize exceptional inventors from Europe and beyond. Okay, now, friends, she has been honored with this award as she has done research successfully in the use of nanotechnology in dentistry, that is filling of, you know, teeth to cure them from, you know, further decaying. So she has done this and she has been awarded, she has been honored with this award. Next question, friends. Who among the following has been appointed as the 10th president of Illinois Institute of Technology in United States of America, USA? So the right answer to this question is option number D, that is Raja Gopal Raghavan. Now, let's play with the option. All the options present here, connect some newses and we're going to discuss all the four newses present in the option. Now, friends, I hope you remember the name of Montek Singh Ahluwalia. In the previous video only, I have discussed a news related to him that he has been named as the member of high-level advisory group. Okay, he has been named as a member of high-level advisory group on sustainable and inclusive recovery and growth. We have discussed this in the previous video. M. Rajeshwar Roy, friends, he is heading, he will head Regulation Review Authority 2.0, which has been initiated or started by your RBI, Reserve Bank of India. Okay. Girish Chandra Chaturvedi, RBI has appointed Girish Chandra Chaturvedi as the part-time chairman of ICICI Bank, friends. I hope you remember this. Mahesh Kumar Jain has been reappointed as the deputy governor of RBI. Now, friends, if I talk about deputy governor, then T. Ravi Shankar has also been appointed as the 4th deputy governor of RBI and he have replaced B.P. Kanungo. Remember, all these things can be asked in your examination. RBI has one governor and 4 deputy governors, friends. The name of the governor is Shaktikanta Das. If I talk about 4 deputy governors, one is your Michael Patra, second is your M. Rajeshwar Roy, third is your M. Kumar, Mahesh Kumar Jain, and fourth is your T. Ravi Shankar. I hope this is clear, friends. Done. So recently, friends, Chennai based engineer, that is Raj Gopal Raghavan, has been appointed as the 10th president of Illinois Institute of Technology in USA. So remember this, friends, it's important. If an Indian becomes a president or a head of an organization which is an international organization, international institute, so that news becomes really very, very important for examination, as in the previous years many questions are asked related to all these things. So friends, question number 6. Dash has announced her 5th book titled The 7 Sins of Being a Mother. Okay, so the right answer to this question is your option number C, that is Tahiri Kashyap Khurana. Tahira Kashyap Khurana is the right answer to this question and we will discuss about all the books, friends. Okay, books and authors are important for examination. Questions are asked related to books and authors. And today we will discuss all the recent books which have been published in 2021. The list is growing big, big, big each and every day, friends. Let's revise everything. So, friends, recently filmmaker writer Tahiria Kashyap Khurana has announced her 5th book titled The 7 Sins of Being a Mother. Okay, remember the name of the book as well as the author. Okay. Other books of Tahira Kashyap Khurana are 12 Commandments of Being a Woman, Cracking the Code, My Journey in the Bollywood, and Your Sold Out. So friends, let's discuss related to all the books recently published in 2021 with the name of their authors. Prakash Javedkar, I hope now you remember The Green Queens of India, A Nation's Pride is being written by Prakash Javedkar. Every time we will discuss any book in this session, obviously I will be adding that book as well as the name of the author in this list. Okay, and every time we will be discussing the question on books and author, we're going to revise all the books discussed and authors. Sushmita Mukherjee, friends, Banj, Incomplete Life for Complete Women is written by Sushmita Mukherjee. Rajiv Malhotra, Artificial Intelligence and the Future of Power, 5 Battleground. Sanjay Baru's, India's Power Elite, Caste Culture and Cultural Revolution. Shakur Rathod's, Life in the Clock Tower Valley. Paul Pickering's, Elephant. Dr. Tahiri Kutubuddin, Arabic Oration, Art and Function. Kalki Glochan, Elephant in the Room. Ravi Shastri, Stargazing, The Players in My Life. David Diop, At Night, All Blood is Black. And your Tahira Kashyap Khurana, The 7 Sins of Being a Mother. I hope all these things are clear. So International Day of Yoga is observed on, friends, it is observed on option number C, that is 21st of June. The International Day of Yoga is observed on 21st of June. The theme for this year 2021 was, friends, Yoga for Wellness. Okay, so remember this, Prime Minister of India has convinced the idea to celebrate International Yoga Day in 2014 at United Nations General Assembly. And recently, 76th, you know, for the 76th session, President of United Nations General Assembly has been appointed and his name is Abdullah Shahid. Remember, he is the foreign minister of your Maldives. Maldives' capital is Male. And friends, India and Maldives signed an MOU on sustainable urban development. Many of time I have discussed all these things and I hope now all these things are on your tips. Okay, so question number 8, friends, World Music Day is observed on. So on 21st of June, your World Music Day was also observed. 2 days were observed. One was World Music Day and one was International Yoga Day. The World Music Day has been celebrated every year on 21st of June. So, first World Music Day was celebrated in your Paris, France, friends, in 1982. And World Music Day is also known as Make Music Day or Fête de la Musique in French, friends. The theme for 2021 is Music at Intersection was the theme for the year 2021. Remember, all the themes, all the days are important for your examination. Now, friends, it's time for memory test. Let me check how much you remember. I've discussed many of the current affair news, many questions with you. Now I'm gonna take and test your memory test to check how much you remember the previous news which we have discussed in the month of May as well as in the month of April. Now it's time for your test. So are you guys ready? So I hope you all are ready. So let's get started. And I request everyone to please post all the questions answer in the homework and comment section. Friends, it is my humble request, everyone who is watching the video has to participate in this test at any cost. So friends, Dash has proposed to construct a 200 bed ICU hospital at Veer Bahadur Singh Sports College in Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh. Now you have to tell me the name. Dash has created world's record by scaling Mount Everest twice in the shortest span of time. Okay, question number 3. Dash Payment Bank has launched your DigiGold. Okay, friends. Dash has launched Koi Innovation and Advanced Research Center in Amsterdam. Please pause the video and quickly write answers for 1, 2, 3, 4 questions and let's move forward. Question number 5, friends. Dash has received International NA Award 2020 for the research into renewable energy sources and energy storage. So, question number 6. Dash Film has won the Best Grand Jury Award for Best Feature Film at India Festival at Los Angeles. World Hunger Day, guys, is observed on Dash. If there is a theme for World Hunger Day, that also you have to mention in the test answer post. Researchers from Dash Institute, the name of the institute, guys, we have discussed this news, has found a way in detecting tropical cyclone in North Indian Ocean earlier than satellite. And your question number 9. UNGA's President Abdullah Shahid has appointed Dash as Chef de Cabinet. RBI has hiked ATM interchange fee transaction from rupees 15 to what? Now friends, all the very best for your test and I want you all to participate. Whosoever watches the video, please participate. Whether you know the answer of 2 questions, 4 questions, 5 questions, just participate there and answer those 2, 3, 4, 5 questions only. It's not a deal. And the person who knows all the 10 questions can answer the 10 questions. Like this, we'll be keeping the memory tests also after some videos so that we are able to connect and revise the previous news which we have discussed. It's not the way that previous news we are covering and we are, you know, it is going out of the memory. That should not happen. Therefore, this revision drill is there. All the best to everyone and please participate in this test. And guys, thank you so much. Thanks for watching. And if you like the video, do hit the like button. Bye-bye. Take care. In the next video, we're gonna meet again.